Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's for me a real pleasure to introduce to you a member of the executive board of the bank, Mr. Jean Hilgers, who has been since 1999, for 12 years, in charge of the microeconomic information department. And some of you who are knowing us know that XBRL International Bank was born in this department. So I think a view from the side of a board member, it's interesting to hear what are his thoughts about the learning curve of XBRL in Belgium and how we implemented it in our bank. The floor is yours, Mr. Hilgers.
Thank you, Luc. Thank you, Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. So as a member of the Board of National Bank of Belgium, it's first my great pleasure to attend this 22nd conference. Another conference for me, it's not the first one. And just to witness and to tell you about the way we consider XBRL in Belgium. Data exchange has always been a major matter of concern in our country for many years. And that's the reason why Belgium authorities in general actually at a quite early stage opted for XBRL for an increasing number of business reportings. My presentation will be divided into a few parts. I will first try and give you immediately the whole range, give you some explanation about the first major operational project developed under XBRL, which is the filing of corporate annual accounts developed within the bank, and about extension afterwards in business reporting when we developed the so-called building block method. I will come back to this later on. And then the last part of this presentation will give you an overview on how XBRL can be used as a tool to further increase the harmonization and the exchange of financial information. Actually, the so-called Central Balance Sheet Office was established in 1978 in the bank, and this is actually a business unit within a bank. The Central Balance Sheet Office has been entrusted actually with two legal assignments. First, and both related to the transition and the transposition of European directives at that time. First, the gathering and individual spreading of all the information contained in the corporate annual account reports, and the second, the handling of standardized data for drawing up of macro statistics. This actually enables the link between macroeconomic information at the corporate level and the macro dimension. And at this time, as you see here on the slide, there are almost 355,000 Belgium and foreign corporations established in Belgium liable to file annual account, which at the Belgium scale, it's quite considerable. Actually, we considered XBRL for the first time in early 2004. That's when the story started in the context of the adoption of the IFRS standards. The format we'd use at that time for electronic filing was not flexible enough to be adapted to IFRS. And a switch to XBRL would provide us, I think that's the way we saw that at that time, but nothing's changed since then. First, to provide us with data in a standard format. It would enable us to prepare the process to allow filing of annual accounts drawn up according to IAS or IFRS when the Belgium authorities would decide to adopt them. And then it could also enable us to facilitate data exchange with other regulators. And finally, we also realized at that time quite quickly that XBRL was a fine way to reduce maintenance costs as well as to simplify maintenance as well. And the first step actually was, I think we were a pioneer, at least in Belgium certainly, starting in 2004, this XBRL project, and the first taxonomy was presented to the stakeholders in 2005. Then 2007, after a big bang, the project was launched, and XBRL replaces the so-called text format used at that time. and that without noticeable change to the end user. The floppy disk used then was also completely given up. And a year later, in 2008, the first annual account of Belgium non-profit institutions, also collected by the bank on a global scale, were filed in the former XBRL file. And since then, all annual accounts filed with the Central Balance Sheet Office are available on the website of the bank in PDF format first, and can be consulted and downloaded free of charge. And I think we can claim that this service made a tremendous success, with about 20,000 consultations a day on average in 2010, which at the Belgium scale is quite noticeable and meaningful. And since February of last year, annual account file in the form of XBRL file are equally available on the website of the bank free of charge, which is another service we offer, and we expect this to be met with an equally important success. So globally, in 2010, last year, there were more than 5 million online consultations of annual account. And as could be expected, the annual account in the form of PDF format were the most popular, with about 96% of all visits. And one important findings we made at that time was basically actually focusing on the nature of the corporation of which annual account are consulted. About two-thirds of a consultation focus on annual account of small and medium-sized corporations, which is basically quite an interesting one, because we could have imagined that actually the consultation would actually be focusing on the large corporation, which is obviously not the case. Now, what are the major, at least in overview, success factors in this story? First of all, I think we succeeded because we provided user-friendly online applications, allowing to draw up, to file, to consult annual account. And this, the application and the user support are free of charge and 24/7 available, which is, of course, quite convenient. The access to the application is quite easy. For filing annual account, it's just necessary to have a digital certificate like the one we have on our ID. It's quite widespread in Belgium. And as concerned the consultation, there is no access control at all. I think it's considered as a public good in Belgium. And so anyone can have access to this without any formality. And of course, next to that, money is in everything. We reduce as to stimulate the behavior of corporation for opting for filing annual account under XBRL project. We reduce by 30 euro the filing fee for companies opting for XBRL, which makes up quite a third of the drop cost reduction, which of course prompted many companies to opt for XBRL. Now, then we went forward and made the use of XBRL also mandatory in Belgium for two major European reporting supervision frameworks. Financial reporting, the so-called FinRep on one hand, and the common reporting of solvency ratio, the so-called CoRep, on the other hand. As you know, FinRep is based on the International Financial Reporting Standards, the IFRS, and CoRep is based on the Basel II requirements. And in order for our reporting financial institutions to make the necessary investment, we made the use of XBRL mandatory for the reporting, as well as FinRep, as well as CoRep. And of course, Belgium already adopted IFRS at that time for the consolidated accounts as early as 2006 onwards. And the use of XBRL was already mandatory at that time, if I get it right. An XBRL taxonomy has been created during the summer of 2005 as an extension of the IFRS taxonomy of the ISCF. And the first official XBRL reports arrived in Belgium during the first half of 2006. Now, I think the European frameworks underline one of the great example of the XBRL-related benefits. A common framework is developed, national, international, cross-sector, and then translated into an XBRL taxonomy. And this taxonomy uniquely defined each concept and dimension so that anyone can reuse them without any doubt about their meaning. enabling such a comparison between different countries, different reporting agents, different sectors, and different countries, of course. And in the concept, in the context of FinRep and CoRep, this implies that the European taxonomy is created and then extended by each country, in this case, national supervisor, to reuse the common concept and create a specific national concept, which is quite a good and convenient way to go forward. No, I think that the success of the central balance sheet project, I think, soon attracted the attention of other public bodies in this Belgium story, Chairman, in charge of other business reportings. And first analysis of the demands and requirements revealed that there were a clear overlap between the content of the specific business reporting requirements and the content of annual accounts. To put it otherwise, many information they needed were basically available in the annual accounts. And in this context, XBRL Belgium has developed the so-called building block method. And this approach is based on a chronological context in which, and the underlying idea is that new business reportings should be built upon existing one as additional layers. And it's in fact much easier for us, at least, to develop new business reporting by recovering information from existing reportings and by asking only those specific missing elements in the in the new reportings. So then by re-asking the whole set of information once again from scratch to every financial institutions. That's the way we work this with this so-called building block method. It actually starts with the introduction with the identification data of the corporation, and of course with our first project, the so-called annual account project, which actually gather all the company accounting data, P&L, balance sheet, and all the other related information. On top of this, on this block of information, we developed new ones. And the first one was the so-called structured corporate survey. Actually, in Belgium, about 20,000 corporations have to disclose information about their activity, employment, profit, cost, investment realized during the previous year. And that's for the sake of macro statistics, what we call national accounts. And the public administration in charge of this, Ministry of Economic Affairs, soon developed a taxonomy and an XBRL application allowing companies to fill in survey about a structure. And the objective of the XBRL project was basically to reduce reporting burden, asking only data once, and to increase the quality of information received, thanks to also, which is another merit of the system, the cross-check we can make from this information with other existing sources. And the first survey in XBRL were filed in November 2009. That was basically the third block here on the slide. And then another one was actually created by the tax administration. They were quite ready to jump into it as well. They launched the so-called corporate tax return, also a building block project, addressing the additional taxonomy related to the filing of corporate income tax. And the objective of this project was basically to cut red tape related to the corporate income tax, then to facilitate the integrated processing among all activities of the tax administration, starting from corporate income tax, VAT, maybe one day exchange right of registry rights, to improve the information exchange between government agencies in general and federal administration in charge of business reporting, National Bank of Belgium as well as National Security Office in particular. And this project is likely to be launched at the end of this month, as far as I know. Then there are two other projects I'd like to mention because they are dear to my heart at the bank. National Bank of Belgium is also in charge of the so-called credit registering in Belgium. Two of them are basically identified. First, it's the Central Individual Credit Register, which is a database created by law to help curb excessive household credit indebtedness And basically, it collects information from every individual's contracting both mortgage loans, consumer credits. And this database contains roughly information about 4.5 million individuals, basically one per household, and 8 million contracts. The current database is in use for 8 years now and should be renewed in the medium term, not necessarily in one go. And the objective is to do so using XBRL application. The second one, it's the Central Corporate Credit Register, which is basically the same, pursuing the same goal, but for corporation. And they're directed mainly at banks or corporate lenders, enabling them to assess the credit risk they incur when granting loan to corporations. The database contained data over 800,000 corporations and self-employed using loans for professional purposes. And for this database as well, a complete refurbishment is underway, and its conversion into XBRL could take advantage of the so-called building block method as well. That's what we expect. And then the last project I'd like to mention here is the so-called XEBR. We have a working group on business register of XBRL Europe, as you know, which has launched this project in the beginning of 2009, aiming at developing a core reference taxonomy, which is called XEBR. And this taxonomy considers concepts such as company identity, corporate key figures, and we think it could play an important role in the so-called interoperability of business registers. Interesting to know is that the working group reuses, in this case, the concepts that are already used in the so-called BACH database, B-A-C-H, which is a database containing harmonized annual accounts and statistics of non-financial corporations, as the one we use in the corporate credit registers, from 9 different European countries, and which has been developed by the European Committee of Central Balance Sheet Data Office. And the next step was to connect existing local taxonomy with a core reference taxonomy so that it became possible to consult and compare information from instance document using various European taxonomies. And in the meantime, I think the first tools are already available and real-life implementation is underway. And I think, as far as I'm informed, you will have a comprehensive overview of the existing solution and real-life implementations of for the collection, storage, management, and rendering of XBRL data in this concept provided in the track 3 of this conference, the so-called interactive data sharing, and I warmly advise you to attend this part of this conference as well. So that's it for today, Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, for this quick overview of the major XBRL-related project in Belgium. But I think the main lessons we have learned so far is that even though important steps have been taken in modernizing business reportings, they are still, and we discover that every day once more, many reasons to keep up with their work and many fields to further investigate. The more you do, the more you have to do in this field. Thank you for this.